Well, now that we've learned about the problems that exist in the Napa River watershed, it's important to think about what we can actually do to address those and come up with solutions to fix the problems. After all, that is one of the fun things about science is we identify a problem and then we get to think of solutions to that problem to solve it. So one of the most simple, at least conceptually, solutions to a lot of our problems is to not develop the land immediately adjacent to streams as much. And that sounds really simple. Just don't build things, including vineyards and houses and barns and all those other things, right up next to creeks. Creeks need to move around. They really benefit from a little bit of buffer, a space next to them that supports wildlife and all kinds of other functions. It filters out pollutants as water runs off into the streams. The hard thing about that in Napa is that the real estate in Napa is amongst the most expensive in the world. So if you ask a landowner living along a stream to just let that go back to being wild, essentially they're giving up a lot of potential income from that land. By not farming it, they are losing something. The good news is in Napa, we've been pretty successful with folks that realize that streams need room to move around, to support fish, to stay clean. And they've been willing to do that exact thing just by setting back, just providing a buffer and not developing right up to the edge of the stream. Or if they have vineyard there, pulling it back some distance to allow for those natural processes to occur. And that has benefits not just to salmon, but to the larger ecosystem. I mean, certainly humans all want clean water, we rely on that. And a whole host of other native animals, for example, in Napa we have beavers and river otters and mink, and then in that riparian area we have bobcats and coyotes and a whole suite of birds that occupy basically the place I'm standing in right now, right adjacent to a river. So it's a really valuable ecosystem. Another solution that's underway in Napa is to improve fish passage by taking out fish passage barriers. And these include things like dams and road crossings and all kinds of other obstructions that humans have put in, many of which aren't really even that useful anymore. So we come across often old structures with no purpose. They don't even impound water for any sort of water use, and they can be taken out. And there's actually been great progress on this in Napa with many partners, private and public, to get a lot of the habitat essentially reconnected. So places that used to be blocked off because of these artificial structures are being reconnected through time. And I see that as a really promising improvement in the watershed.